hungry for Jesus Christ? Are you thirsty today? Because I don't want another religion in my life. I left religion. I left Islam. I hate it. I just want to be free. I just want to be free. And then something happens to that person, a touch or a breeze or in a form of a wind. I know it is Jesus. Maybe you are sitting here today and you are saying, I need that transformation because I don't want to be stuck in this place anymore. Now this is the biggest harvest time. This is the revival time for God to come and change everything. Welcome to Embracing New Life. Embracing New Life. Today, I have a special guest. He is the founder of David Turner International Ministries, and he preaches the gospel to all over the world. More than 2 million people already heard the gospel message from him. And today, we are talking about signs and wonders and miracles of Jesus Christ, all for his glory. But I want to challenge you today, because God wants to challenge your faith today. I heard a preacher said long time ago, God is limited, he said, and I was in shock. How could he say God is limited? Then he shouted all the more. He said, God is limited with you and with me. So today is the day we need to get God out of the box, and he's going to show you his miracles. He's going to challenge your faith, and he's going to take you to the next level of glory, next level of faith, today, right now. Thank you so much for being with me today. Welcome. Welcome, David.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
From your experience and healing someone, seeing his knees, and he started playing again at NFL, I mean, this is huge faith boost.
Yes.
You started believing God can do this for everybody.
Yes.
And how it became a ministry. Tell us about it.
Well, you know, I learned so many things. You know, God is never doing just one thing. When he's healing someone, he's not only changing their life, but many people who will hear the testimony. He's helping me grow in learning how he does this. There were so many things I learned along the way. One thing I want to share right now, I think it's very important. You know, we all talk miracles, 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 and I see God do so many miracles. But there's something called healing. In fact, healings in the Bible, gifts of healings. And there is a difference. And many times people don't understand this. A healing can take an hour, a day, a week, a month, a year. You have to stand and believe in faith. A miracle happens instantaneously and out of the bounds of natural law. God has done both in me, and I've seen him do both in people. Sometimes what happens as a Christian, we muster up, we pray for 1 second. Usually it's not even a prayer of faith. Oh God, if it's your will, which is a faith-breaking prayer, or, you know, let's see if God will do it. And they open their eyes, they don't see it instantly, and they think nothing happened. But what I see is that we believe. I always tell people, today's the day of my miracle. But if I don't receive it today, then tomorrow, today's the day of my miracle.
Amen.
Today's the day.
Amen.
And I keep
declare
saying it. People, you know what they say? But how long do I have to believe in faith? This is a key right here. You know what I tell people? Hebrews 11:6, it says, apart from faith, we cannot please God. We must believe that not only he exists, for even the demons believe he exists.
That's right.
But that he's a rewarder of those who seek him. So I tell people, you're not believing in faith to get your miracle, you're believing in faith to please your God. But when you please your God, you'll get your miracle or your healing. He knows what you need. And every one of us, it's different. Sometimes I've needed a miracle. Sometimes I thought I'd get a miracle and I had to pray for 3 months to get what it was.
Yes.
So, but God is always answering, but our job is to stand in faith. People will say, how long do I have to stand in faith, brother? You know what I tell them? Are you dead yet? If you're not dead, then you believe that Jesus can transform your life today.
Amen.
Every day, God, I'm here. In fact, just a fun story on this. You know, I've had several things happen in my body. People think healing evangelists don't get sick.
Doctors need doctors, right?
I get attacked. I mean, I've prayed for people that are paralyzed in their leg, and the devil jumps off them and jumps on me, and my leg would be paralyzed for 3 days and at the beginning, and I'd have to pray and pray, and after 3 days, God would give me grace and mercy, and I'd be set in freedom. So things happen, and I've been through a lot in my own physical body. So But one of the stories I want to share for a moment is I had psoriasis all over my body, hundreds of, it looked like I was literally bleeding in 100 spots on my body. Wow. And I would pray for people and they'd be healed of psoriasis and I would still have it. But I never get, oh, bitter or God, why me? Or why is it taking so long? I'm rejoicing at their miracle. Some people think if I don't get my miracle, they're not happy for someone else. Mm-hmm. When I see someone else's miracle, I'm rejoicing for them.
Yes.
But I'm also rejoicing for me because the Bible says, Romans 2:11, God is not a respecter of persons. What he did for them, he'll do it for me.
Amen.
So when I see that, it confirms and encourages me to keep believing. Mm-hmm. But all these people are getting healed, I'm not. One night I'm laying in my bed at night, and I'll never forget, I was bleeding all over my body to where I'm sticking to the sheets. It felt like I ran through a glass window. My body is burning. And I raised my hands to the heavens, and I always remember how the enemy, one of the things he's called is the accuser of the brethren.
So true.
And he stands before God, and I'm envisioning the devil standing before God and saying, well, look at him. Sure, you give him everything you want and this and that, and he's happy or he has money or whatever. So of course he loves you. So much like with Job.
Yes.
And so I laid there in this pain, and I raised my hands to the heaven, envisioning the enemy before Jesus accusing and saying, Jesus, whether I live or die, you're still Jehovah Rapha. You are the Lord who healeth me, Exodus 15:26. Mm. I give you glory. I give you praise. It's like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego when they said, my God will deliver me, and even if he doesn't, I will worship him. And when that's our heart, God will always move on our behalf. Amen?
Amen.
I had another time, I had sugar diabetes. My sugar went to 400 points. At over 300, you can go into a coma. Mm-hmm. And I'm at 400 points. The doctors told me, my blood pressure was 160 over 110. They said, you'll be on blood pressure medicine and you'll be on diet, on insulin for the rest of your life. I told the doctor, I said, I'm a healing evangelist and I teach people Jesus heals. He was so mad at me, he didn't want to let me leave the office. He made me sign a release because he said to me, your organs are in an acid bath and you will die in 3 months if you don't take this insulin. I walked out of there. I said, Jesus is my healer. No major thing, but James 5:15, it says, pray the prayer of faith and the sick will be healed. Anoint with oil. Well, my sicknesses were inside. So I took some olive oil and I put it on a teaspoon and I would just hold it up and say, blood of Jesus. And I would take the olive oil. And within 3 days, my blood pressure was 120 over 78. Has been that way for the last 15 years.
Hallelujah.
But my blood sugar was still like 400. 10 days later, mind you, this doctor told me I had 90 days to live. I'm doing the same thing, except now I'm taking the oil and I'm going, blood of Jesus, and my hand's shaking as I'm getting closer to this, you know, what the doctor said I would die. And I didn't know much about it or diabetes, but I listen to the doctor and I'm scared, but I'm believing Jesus.
Absolutely.
But, you know, about 3 weeks into it, all of a sudden, my sugar dropped to 120, and I was healed of the diabetes.
That's
so
awesome.
You see, sometimes he does a miracle, sometimes he does a healing. Mm-hmm. There's been times where I've had to wait a year, where I've prayed and prayed to see something happen. I'll ask him when I'm with him one day, why a year, and why the, I always say, God is not Jehovah how, Jehovah why, Jehovah when.
I love that.
Amen.
Amen.
So
Amen.
He is the healer. I stand on your word. I quote the word back to Jesus. You said you're the healer,
Amen.
Exodus 15, 6.
Yes.
You said Isaiah 53,
yes.
4 and 5. You said Matthew 8, 17. You said 1 Peter 2,
Amen.
24. You said Proverbs 4, 22 and 3, 8. Your word is healing to my skin. It's marrow to my bones. Mm-hmm. And I quote the word to Jesus.
I want to ask you something because this is amazing. You are talking about when I met you at Sid Roth, I just was like, the spirit was like, I was so happy. He was bearing a witness within me.
Amen.
And because you stand on the word of God, your ministry is founded on Jesus and the word of God. That's
yes.
very important. And I always tell people, praying the word of God is praying the will of God.
Yes.
And when we pray the will of God, it is an answer prayer.
Yes.
So that is very important that you quote back the scriptures to the Lord, not because he doesn't know his word, but also you said something.
He loves it.
But you said something yesterday, and I posted today on my Facebook. I want you to say it. For angels, it's not possible for them to understand unbelief.
Yeah.
Tell us in a, you know, I don't want to paraphrase it.
Sure.
I want you to say it.
Well, one time the Holy Spirit spoke to me, and again, I only say the Holy Spirit said when he really said. Because the first time I heard the Lord speak to me, he said, David, many people run around saying, God said, and I've never said it. So I have the fear of God. So only when he really speaks, plus usually it's something very wise that I couldn't have thought of. I wish I could. But one time the Holy Spirit speaks to me and he says, David, you, meaning you as people, have all you can do to muster up the faith to believe for one second that that miracle is possible. He said, I want you to understand something. There is a place in the heavenly realm where the angels are, where as much as you can't fathom that it will happen, they can't fathom that it wouldn't happen. And I thought about it, and he said, go to that place, you'll find your healing. So you see, I thought about that. Why is it they can't fathom? Because they've been with Jesus since the foundation. They saw him speak the world into place. They've seen that every word he's ever spoken has always happened. They watched Satan fall from heaven. Of course, when Jesus says something, they don't go, ooh, I wonder if it'll happen this time. They know it's going to happen. When we go into that place, when I'm in front of someone in a wheelchair, I never look at the doctor report. I can't look at the metal chair. I go to that place in the heavenly realm. When I'm praying, I'm in that place with Jesus where it's unthinkable, it's unimaginable to think it wouldn't happen. I'm shocked if a miracle doesn't happen. When I go places, most people are shocked when it does happen. Even I say, do you believe? They say, yes, I believe. When they have a miracle, they're like, oh my God, I can't believe it. I said, I thought you said you believed. I always tell people, always amazed, never surprised.
I remember that.
Amen.
Yes, that's very good.
So go to that place, because in our place as humans, we have so much doubt. Even we see miracles, or even we believe, we have. That's why the centurion said, I believe, help me in my unbelief. Mm-hmm. And God will answer that prayer too.
Yes.
If we can't believe, just instead of beating ourselves up, just say, Jesus. In fact, for those who can't believe, I always say this, just like, the way we get saved is Jesus is righteous and we are unrighteous. Mm-hmm. What does he do? It was a divine exchange. He exchanged at the cross his righteousness for our unrighteousness, his holiness for our sin.
Yes.
So the same way he made that exchange. When you come and say, Jesus, I believe, help me in my unbelief, you know what happens? He takes his perfect faith and our imperfect faith. He takes our doubt and he gives us his perfect faith. He counts us as righteous. He does the miracle.
Amen. So he flows through us with the faith.
It's his perfection that makes us sinless, not that we're sinless. It's the same thing, his grace, that he comes and he gives us that account to our account, and and then we're considered faithful.
Wow.
So,
that's
amen.
That's so beautiful. Amen. Amen. It's so true. And also coming to that place that where you are understanding, seeing it from the heavenly realms.
Yes.
And only you can do it just because of him.
Yes. That he is the healer.
He is the healer, and giving all the credit and the glory him.
Absolutely.
To him is a big step for everybody.
I learned very early on several secrets. There's no formula in Jesus, because it's not like, oh, turn your hand this way and do this and do that. It's not about, because the Holy Spirit wants us to learn how to listen to a still small voice. So it's something different all the time. It's about being aware and abiding in him. But if there was ever a formula, he taught me one thing early on, which is lift up the name of Jesus, speak the pure word of God, and then the Holy Spirit comes. Mm-hmm. People say, well, why? So biblically, well, how do we back that up? Mm-hmm. Well, the Bible says that when we lift up, John 16, verse 13 and 14, if you help me lift up, then send the Holy Spirit to help me lift up Jesus, to turn people from the lies of the devil to the truth of God. So when we start to say Jesus, I tell people, even if you don't just start, you don't know how to pray, just say Jesus, Jesus. I go to India, there'll be 50,000 people. They're Hindu. They've never known Jesus. They just start saying Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. So what's happening? When you start to say Jesus, when you speak the word, again, Psalm 107:20, he'll send his word and heal you. So it's not a soulish word, it's touching the spirit.
Amen.
Because why? His words, John 6:63, they are life and spirit. So when you lift up Jesus, the Holy Spirit comes. When you speak the word of God, it's life and spirit. The word of God, see, many people think they quote the Bible. The Bible says the Bible says. But nothing happens. It's because they're not believing. But when we believe the word, the power of the Holy Spirit is behind it. The word says in the 2 Timothy 3:16 that the word is God breathed.
Amen.
The breath of God is behind the words you're now speaking. That is the Holy Spirit. So it is not the logos of the word, the letter of the word that heals you. So it is the revelation. So here's what happens. The Spirit gives the revelation. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 3, verse 6, that the letter kills, but the Spirit gives life.
Amen.
So what happens is when you're speaking not by the letter of the word, but by the Spirit. So the letter of the word, just to explain this for a moment, when we're watching the logos or the letter of the word, when we're seeing the internet, newspapers, radio, that's all the logos, letter of the word. And that letter is killing the people. But the spirit behind the word, if you look in the book of Revelation, what does it say? Revelation chapter 1 says that John, the apostle, he was what? In the spirit. And when he was in the spirit, what happened? He got the revelation.
That's
so what happens is the spirit gives the revelation.
Amen.
The revelation produces the life.
Wow.
Well, actually, the revelation gives the faith, and the faith produces the life.
I feel the power of the Holy Spirit right now here. And there are people watching this broadcast from all over the world. There are sick people.
Amen.
There are people maybe holding their babies in their arms.
Yes.
And they cannot take it to a hospital.
Yes.
There are people that they have cancer and they are just tired of going to chemotherapy again.
Yes.
And maybe there are some people that cancer resurrected again and they just don't want to do life anymore.
Yeah.
So would you please look at this camera and start speaking healing power of Jesus Christ to completely and utterly cleanse them from whatever they have right now.
And we'll pray again for that right now. I want to tell you, this is good news for you, child of God. God gave me a promise, Exodus 34:10. He said, I will do miracles, signs, and wonders never before seen in any nation in all the earth. The people you live amongst will see the works that I, the Lord, will do for you. For several years, I pondered that and I prayed, Lord, what does this mean? And is it literal or figurative? And you know what he showed me? Because I said, what hasn't Jesus done? What hasn't been done? He said, the gift I'm going to do for you is all over the world. I'm going to heal people right through the television. He's actually proven that. I've been on TV and we've received thousands of phone calls. One show, there were 6,200 calls when people were healed. I said, the Lord said, tell people, share the message, tell them to call in if they've been healed. You just call, you send an email for this program and you say, I was healed, I was touched.
Yes.
And you just say, God, I'll give the testimony if you touch me right now. I'm telling you, I don't have to be there. It's the Spirit of the Lord, it's not me. He is the healer, I'm the one who builds your faith. But he will do it through the anointing that he's given for my life, right through the television. You can be healed right now. We're gonna pray for you. What I want you to do, if you don't know Jesus, simply say right now, Jesus, show yourself as real to me. I'll receive you, I'll believe you, I'll follow you from this day forward. And just open your heart, child of God. Right now, you know, the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 1:18, it says, the cross is foolishness to perishing people.
Yes.
But for those of us being saved, it's the power of God. So right now, when you close your eyes, look to the cross. Mm-hmm. Don't look to me, just look to the cross of Jesus Christ. Put your hand on the part of your body that hurts right now. If it's a headache, put it on the back of your head, on your stomach, on your knees, your back, whatever it is. You just put your hand and you look to the cross and say, Jesus, right now, touch me now. Touch me now. The power is in Jesus. It's in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, unless Jesus heals in Jeremiah 17, 14, we are not healed. There's no name above the earth, below the earth, or upon the earth, yes. Acts 4:12, that saves apart from the name of Jesus. The word salvation comes from the Greek word soso, which means healing. Mm-hmm. So it's deliverance, wholeness, healing. So he wants to save you. It's not just for eternal life, it's for heaven right now. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Romans 14, 17, what is that kingdom? Love, joy, peace, and righteousness in the Holy Spirit. So it's hard to walk in joy and peace when you're sick and hurting. So Jesus wants to heal it right now so that you can experience the kingdom right now on earth. Love, joy, peace, and righteousness in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. So right now, just close your eyes, child of God, in the name of Jesus. Right now, God Jehovah, God Jesus Christ, God Holy Spirit, you who are the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, and the Rock of Ages, Jesus Christ, you said, Isaiah 53, verse 4 and 5, I was pierced for your transgressions, bruised for your iniquity. By my wounds you are healed. You said, Matthew 8, 17, you died for our sickness and disease. 1 Peter 2, 24, you bore our curse, for cursed is the one who hangs upon a tree. Jesus, you died for us. You were nailed to that cross to set us in freedom. You said, Deuteronomy 7, verse 13 to 15, I heal you because I love you. You said your word, you will send your word and heal us. Psalm 107, verse 20. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bind, rebuke, and destroy the work of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, over the lives of all the people, I bind every evil spirit, unclean, medium, familiar spirits, lying, seducing, false spirits. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I cast out every cancer, cell, bone, blood, body chemistry, hormonal disorders, AIDS, Alzheimer's, MS, fatigue, anorexia, bulimia, hypochondria. Right now, I plead the blood of Jesus over the children of God, the people of God, those who are believing right now. We look unto the cross in the name of Jesus. The fire anointing of God, rivers of living water flow through you now. In the name of Jesus, every migraine spirit is bound. Every deaf and dumb spirit, mute spirits, tinnitus, evil spirits, every evil spirits of sinuses, allergies, blindness, glaucoma, mental disorders, ADHD, schizophrenia, bipolar, mental retardation, Down syndrome, sickle cell anemia, fibromyalgia, body weaknesses. Right now, every evil spirit, all the arrhythmia come out, high blood pressure, asthma, arthritis, paralysis, psoriasis, eczema, diabetes. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I heal you and set you free. All the sicknesses right now, I heal right now. Kidneys, liver, gallbladders, pancreas. Right now, in the name of Jesus, all the lungs be opened up. All the breathing restored. Right now, resurrection power, fire anointing of God, rivers of living water flow right now in your life in the name of Jesus. Come on, Jesus, right now. Children of God, whatever you couldn't do, if you couldn't bend and move, start to bend and move. This is not a courtesy prayer. We're believing for the miracle of God right now. Touch the hem of the robe of Jesus Christ. Reach up right now. Oh, right now, the Bible says, Revelation 22, verse 2, that there's a tree of life in heaven whose leaves are for the healing of the nation. In your mind's eye, reach up right now. Touch those leaves. The tree of life, his name is Jesus Christ. Oh, right now, Jesus. Right now, Jesus, you are the healer. You are the restorer. In the name of Jesus Christ, power of God and resurrection power flow right now in the lives of the people. I cast out every evil spirit. I heal them right now for the glory of God. God, they must be able to do what they couldn't do before. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I heal every neck. Right now, every bone that's out of place. Right now, back, the disc, sciatic nerve, veins, arteries. Right now, spinal cord. Every sickness, come out of the children of God right now. Yes. Those who are believing you right now, let them receive the miracle, receive the healing in the name of Jesus. Yes. Amen, 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 and amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
I thank you so much because I feel the power of God right now, like electricity from the top of my head to the bottom of my feet. And when you were praying, God spoke and said, I am healing someone from lupus right now.
Amen.
I am healing someone from Lyme disease right now.
Amen.
And half a dozen people got healed from AIDS during this broadcast.
Amen.
Please be obedient and write and give a praise report.
Amen.
A praise to God. It's all for his glory. But I know hundreds or even thousands of people got healed right now.
Amen.
Because I could just feel the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Just receive it. Receiving is faith. You see, you need to just receive it right now and don't doubt. receive it in Jesus' name. Thank you. How powerful is that? And, you know, today, maybe until today, you have been wanting to have this experience that we are talking about here. And David is teaching us. And you want to have that experience right now. You can have that. Remember, when you start saying the name of Jesus, and when you are repeating the scriptures and declaring them, faith comes through hearing.
Yes.
Faith comes through hearing. And I tell people, you want to declare things, you cannot do it in your heart. Some prayers you can pray in your heart. God hears it. Of course, He knows before the words come out of your mouth. He knows every word that you are going to say. But when you are declaring into existence, when you are declaring God's word into your circumstances, like imagine yourself. I always imagine myself. The sword is coming out of my mouth and cutting the things, cutting the chains and ending the sicknesses and the trials. It has a power. So we live in a voice-activated universe.
Yes.
It is voice-activated universe. With your voice, you command. God, Jesus spoke in Mark chapter 11, 22, 23, 24. Read this. You can command your mountain, thy mountains to be removed in Jesus' name. He didn't say think about it. He didn't say wish. He said, command. So what is in commanding? There's power. There's faith. And what I like what David said was, just say the name.
Amen.
Name of Jesus. I heard a story about Smith Wigglesworth raising a dead person. From that, he raised him up. Everybody, of course, Jesus did it. But everybody started, all these prayer warriors started just saying, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Maybe today you don't know how to pray. Maybe you don't know what to say. Just start saying the name wherever you are right now. Jesus, Jesus, in the name of Jesus to my circumstance. Jesus to my cancer, to bow down to Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you can receive Him into your heart with one prayer. You just need to say, Jesus, come and live inside of me. I believe you are the Son of God. I believe you died on the cross for my sins. I believe you rose from the death on the third day. And I invite you into my heart, Jesus. Forgive my sins and make my heart your home. Be the center of my heart. And that is only the beginning. Because God wants to visit you. He wants to reveal things to you, just like David said. He wants to reveal. Holy Spirit is the revealer of mysteries. He wants to reveal things to you. Just ask Him. Come, Holy Spirit, Spirit of truth.
Amen.
And show me Jesus. Teach me the Father. Show me. Reveal to me. Reveal to me. I want to know Jesus more, right?
Amen.
And the second one?
I want all you have for me, and I want to know you better.
I want to know you better, Jesus, and I want all you have for me. Pray that. Pray this prayer today. In Jesus' name, God bless you. I love you, but remember, Jesus Christ loves you unconditionally because He's the one who died on the cross for you. Until next time.
I was diagnosed with a stage 4 melanoma cancer in March of 2011. At that time, I was told that I had about a 5% chance to live, and I'd probably live about 6 months.
So, tell me the specific type of cancer.
Yeah, stage 4 melanoma cancer. The Lord led David to come to San Antonio. He did, in fact, come to San Antonio, and we had it at our house. On that day that he prayed for me, I was weak. I was just, there were no medicines that were working at the time. I also had a real significant pain in my side from where I'd had a surgery. I went up for prayer from David, and the Lord really just anointed and worked through him. We could see it in various people. And by the time I went up and he prayed for me, I walked away from there. I knew I felt different, and I realized that my side was not hurting. And then there had been an immediate healing on my side. Now, I can just tell you that a year from that time, this is March of 2014, that I've had no more transfusions. I'm taking another medicine, which works. The Lord has used that. I know the Lord's anointed work through David was part of the Lord's process of my healing. I'm back to where I'm working. I'm exercising. I'm busy. I'm active with children, grandchildren. I just, you know, praise the Lord. I can just say this to anyone out there that has a need of healing, has a need of hurt, has pain, has discouragement, despondency, that the Lord's anointed through David, that Jesus really, you can feel the sense and the presence of Jesus through David.
God bless you. We're going to see it.
This program is made possible by friends and partners of Isik Abla Ministries. If you'd like to support our ministry, please go to our website at www.isikabla.com. There you can make a secure, tax-deductible donation. Our vision is to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ with a message of salvation, freedom, and healing for the transformation of the Muslim world and bring revival to the body of Christ. We thank you for your support.